what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in a Cube. And in this video, I'm going to show you how you can add calculation groups to your model with just one click. Stay tuned. If you're finding this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right. So calculation groups, done a couple of videos, there's lots of blogs, there's lots of documentation. A lot of people are using calculation groups, but when you start creating your calc group, it can be a little tedious. You know, every time I start a new model, I got to create this calc group. And it's a lot of times the exact same calculation groups. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can add it with one click. Bernat over at sbrina-ba.com wrote a really good blog post, and he wrote this script that does it for you. The blog post walks you through how you can add these calculation groups without right click, add calc group, right click, add item. He wrote a script that'll do it for you, and it's really nice. I'm gonna show you how you can add that calc group with one click. All right, so you guys know I like to do enough of all this talking. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. Let's say you have your model and you wanna create a calc group that does time intelligence or period intelligence. It's a big debate about time and period intelligence. And so I wanna add it for, let's say, sales, my sales measures. You can see that I started doing it, and then I started doing it for freight, and I was about to do it for quantity, and then I ran across that blog post. This works with Tabular Editor 2 and Tabular Editor 3. Yes, you need both. And Tabular Editor 2, you need to run the script. In Tabular Editor 3, that's where the one click comes in. Big shout out to Daniel Octacure. I think that's how you pronounce Daniel's last name, for all the great work on Tabular Editor. Okay, enough, back to my machine. Once you have Tabular Editor installed, you can launch Tabular Editor 3 and then head over to the blog. And down in the blog, there's a Git repo. You go out to the Git repo, you copy this script, okay, right here. You copy all of this. Once Tabular Editor 3 opens up, you can go to the Tom Explorer, and you can see here's my model, okay? I don't have any calc groups. I want to create a calc group. And normally what you would do is you would right click somewhere and start creating your calculation group. That's not what we want to do. You guys know how I am. I'm not lazy, just really efficient. You can go in the ribbon here in the menu and choose new C# script and paste that entire script that they provided for us in the blog post. You got to make a few changes. So whatever you want the calc group to be named, you can go update that. But the important thing is you need to find the fact table. So in my case, it's internet sales. So I'm going to type internet sales right there. Make sure you have the date that you want to use from your fact table. In my case, it is the order date. And then you need to make sure what your date table name is. And so in my case, it's calendar. So I need to go update this. Make sure you go through and set these values up. And he does a good job of explaining all of this in his blog post. So if I run this up, I get an error. It says, hey, you need to select some measures. So which measures do you want this calc group to affect? So basically, I want them to affect freight, quantity, and sales. So I'm going to go ahead and choose sales amount, hold down control, choose quantity, hold down control, and choose freight. And then I'm going to go ahead and press play. You're going to see, boom, it adds my calc group for me. This is nice. And if I save this, it'll save it back to my model, which is exactly what I want. But if you're using Tabular Editor 3, there's just a little something that Daniel showed me that I just have to show in this video. We're going to do this in one click for not just this model, but for all subsequent models. So let me show you what I'm talking about. So let's delete this. And what we're going to do is we have our script. We're going to see this little button right here. We're going to save this as a macro. So I'm going to call this time intelligence. And I know someone that joins our live stream all the time. He's like, no, it's period intelligence. I'm going to call it time intelligence. You can actually take a look at all your macros. If you go to view and go to macros, you can see all the macros that are there. So I have my time intelligence macro. And then what you do is right click on the ribbon and choose customize. And then you can add your own toolbar. So I'm going to call this add calc groups and click OK. And so you can see I have this little space that's added. And then what I would do is I would go to commands, find macros. There we go. There's my macro. I'm going to click it and I'm going to drag it over here. Boom. And I'm going to close this. And I go back to my Tom Explorer and watch this. I'm going to select those exact same measures. I'm going to press time intelligence. Boom. It automatically did it for me. And then I'm going to save this. And then I'm going to go back over to my Power BI desktop. It says, hey, you want to refresh? Click refresh. And there's my calc group. Drag it onto the design surface. Check this out. Make it a slicer. Boom. Let's create a quick matrix here. And then we'll add state, province. And then if I add my measure, I know the report's not too pretty, but I was just really excited about this. So if I add my measure, I can see previous year, year over year. You know, if I do a multi-select, I can see all of this stuff right there in my report. And with just one click. But now, what's really impressive about this, I'm gonna open up another Power BI desktop file. Then I'm gonna launch Tabular Editor and watch this. In another Power BI desktop file, there's no time intelligence here. I'm gonna go ahead and launch Tabular Editor. I was so excited when I saw this. What you're gonna see when it opens, you'll see a new menu bar here, and you'll see it's called time intelligence. So if I go here and select a few measures, let's choose this one, and this one, and click time intelligence, I look down at the bottom, it adds it, save it back to my model. I go over to that report. It says, hey, refresh it, the report and the model. And now I have my time intelligence in my model with just one click. What? This is bananas. Big shout out to Bernard over at esbrina-ba.com. And a big shout out to everyone that contributed to his blog post and helped him out. It gave him more information on how to set this script up. All right, what do you guys think? Are you using calc groups? Have you figured out a way to do your calc groups? One click, I'd love to know. Let's continue the conversation where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.